Today I went into Guy's in St. Thomas's Hospital to deliver a letter to Jenny and Lewis, who looked after Boris Johnson when he had COVID-19. And this letter is also to get 7 nurses in total to come and sit for a portrait. Now, it takes guts just to go to Tesco's and buy food, whereas you had people coming out of retirement, fighting the front line and dying. And I did the 5K run. I raised £5. I banged my pots outside as well. But I felt like if they're going to go and die, it needs to be appreciated. I'm a painter. All I do is paint. Yet these guys have to deal with loss. They have to overcome stress. They have to go home to their families and pretend it's all normal. It's a different world. It's a different world. And I wanted to give them a good tribute and try and raise money for the NHS. About to paint Jenny McGee. I don't think I'm nervous, but I just don't want to up. It's pretty amazing we managed to get Jenny McGee to come and pose for us. It's going to be amazing, to be fair. Try not to put pressure on myself, try to stay calm, just focus on the job, do my best. It's pretty amazing how things have turned, if I'm going to be honest, because went from painting athletes and painting all the sporting heroes of the UK to now painting the real, I mean, not, you know, dissing the sport heroes, but these guys, the NHS and all the nurses and the people in that industry, they're the real heroes, if I'm going to be honest. Imagine every day going into work knowing that there's 100% coronavirus hanging around. Like, it's there. You've got to have amazing courage to do that and real selfless behavior and selfless character.
I've worked in intensive care for a long time now, so I've become, in a way, quite immune to it in a way, but you're still, when you're there, you're very empathetic, but you learn to leave it at the door when you go home. There's a huge focus on wellness and taking time to think about what you're going through and how that's affecting you, and the hospital has a big focus on having people for us to talk to.
You have, especially during the pandemic, you have moments of utter despair. It's very sad, you're seeing awful things happen, but you kind of, luckily it seems to be happening wave, and your friends and colleagues kind of bring you back up. I've met the most amazing people in the world doing my job. Maybe cry.
Sure.
it's a good job. It's hard work, and it's not. I don't know why I'm crying.
This is an amazing interview.
It's humbling. It's sad sometimes. It's like inspiring. It's incredible. We've thrust into the limelight recently, but we've been doing this job for a whole of our careers. Every winter we have a flu season where we're working incredibly hard. It's been exceptionally hard this time round, but
on the hazardous air response team, we deal with high risk diseases. When COVID came about, our unit set up the Nightingale Ambulance Service station. So we worked in conjunction with the Nightingale, and we do most of the transfers, really. Because of our special
Of course, skills. You already have the kit, I guess.
I lost the number of journalists and people trying to contact me, but I believe in terms of messages, notifications, we're around 3,000, kind of. And the reason why I pick up this project is because it's something quite different, something that I never thought that could happen. And because you are also raising money as a charity for NHS, I think it's great. Absolutely, because you're a great artist and I really like the way that you paint.
But I think it's also important to educate people as to what exactly is happening, to tell them the real score. I think transparency is important, And for the people at home, I think it's imperative that they will listen to the government as well and the health experts.
Respect the service, respect the NHS, it's the most incredible thing that we have.
Everyone has done so well up until now with lockdown, but people just really need to think about what they're doing. Don't rush out and see Nana and Granddad because they're still a very vulnerable group and you could still give it to them.
People shouldn't see it as we're heroes, we're doing our job and we're being paid to do our jobs and we're doing it with the best we can. But we're also putting ourselves now in a dangerous situation that we've never had to do before. I mean, some of our colleagues have died doing this.
What a pleasure and an honour it has been to get to know these people. And I hope the paintings are appreciated and I hope they raise the funds to fight this deadly virus. Thank you.